As we begin on this Sunday morning, we just first of all want to thank each and every one for being here at One Accord Church this morning. We're glad to have you all with us. And for those that's viewing us live, whether it's streaming or on our website, we invite you to go to our website, which is oneaccordchurch.net. You can go to our website and you can catch not only our services, but you can go back date and different ones from the past. But as well, we'd like for you to send us a prayer request need or whatever message you may. You can do that through the contact of the pastor and send me your messages or requests, and I'll make sure we get back up with you as well. And for those that's on our television programs, we do want to thank you for tuning in to our services this morning. And we just want to wish you all over the world, wherever you are, happy Mother's Day to our moms. We just thank the Lord for you so much. And we also invite you to join us if you're viewing us this morning and you're looking for a church that just simply believes in the Bible. We don't add to it. We don't take away from it. We don't have to give it a different name. We just simply believe in the Word of God. And if you believe in the Word of God, we'd love for you to come join us. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. As we begin this morning, you know, oftentimes when we think about Mother's Day, we have a whole lot we can consider. There are many mothers in the Bible that we can consider on Mother's Day. But also with that being said, you know, we got examples of mothers. Eve, the mother of us all. Or Hannah, she was the mother of Samuel. Or even Mary, the mother of Jesus. But we're going to do something a little different this morning for mothers. This is going to be about Jochebed, the mother of Moses. You didn't even know that, did you? What the mother of Moses did for him. We want to go to her this morning because I really believe with all my heart, this was a mother that was, if you know anything about Jochebed, the mother, the biological mom of Moses. They went through a really, really hard time. The children of Israel were in bondage to Egypt. And they were slaves. They were making bricks and building everything for them. And they were really living in a very, very hard, hard time. And we also know, as we're going to look in scriptures in Hebrews 11, in verse 23, as we begin, not only was she a mother that lived difficult times. Why was it difficult? Because let me tell you why. All the male babies were under a sentence of death. Yeah. And that's the reason why Moses became so important. She acted in faith, this mother of Moses, and entered God's hall of fame in Hebrews 11. If you know anything about Hebrews 11, Hebrews 11 is called the hall of fame for faith. If you read Hebrews 11, you will see by faith, it's all through it, whether it's Isaac, Jacob, Joseph, Abraham, Moses, and on, so many of them. And that's why she entered to the hall of fame of faith because of what she did. But I'd like for you, if you will, when your Bibles go into Hebrews chapter 11 in verse 23, and follow along with me in your Bibles, if you will, please. I want to make sure everyone gets there. Hebrews chapter 11, verse 23. And those that are viewing us live, we want to thank you for that as well. We have a lot of our folks that are out sick, that are recovering. We want to let you know that our prayers is with you always. All those in our nursing homes and rest homes as well. We just want to invite you to open your Bibles up and follow along with us as we read the Word of God this morning. In Hebrews 11, 23, are we there? Amen. Follow along. By faith, Moses, when he was born, was hid 3 months of his parents because they saw he was a proper child. And they were not afraid of the king's commandment. By faith, Moses, when he was come to years, refused to be called the son of Pharaoh's daughter, choosing rather to suffer affliction with the people of God than to enjoy the pleasures of sin for a season. Esteeming the reproach of Christ greater riches than the treasures in Egypt. For he had respect unto the recompense of the reward. In verse 27, by faith he forsook Egypt, not fearing the wrath of the king. For he endured as seeing him who is invisible. Now, as we look at this, this mom, how do we tie this mom in? Well, in verse, we need to break this down, because Jochebed, the mother of Moses, when it said in verse 23 that he was a proper child, this mom of Moses, she first of all saw the potential in her son. She saw the potential. Moms can always see things that we can't. You know, I've always noticed that whenever, before we reach teenage years, they're the smartest people on planet Earth. But then we go to that teenage stage and they don't know nothing. Right? We all know how that feels, because we were there and now we're here. If I only had listened to Mom, I could have saved a whole lot of headache. Amen? Amen. But the thing about it was, she saw the potential in Moses, because she said he was a proper child. You know, this further backs up in Scripture about, you know, believe it or not, the Scripture tells us, even in the Old Testament, even in the New Testament, about different things that was said about Moses, even from the mom. The mom, actually, if you will please follow along with me, I got a couple of verses of Scripture I'd like to share with you about how Moses, his mom, she saw something that was very different about Moses. And she wanted to make sure that he understood it. In fact, in your Bibles in Exodus chapter 2, verse 2, I want you to turn there, and I want take your time, just not too long. But we want you to find this Scripture, because I want you to see a couple of things in that about Moses. Was Moses special? Was it something that, oh, well, here's another person, what are we going to do with him? No, God has a plan for every single human being put on this earth. And we say, well, what in the world happened? Well, what in the world happened was the world. Yeah. What in the world happened? We just said it, the world. The thing about it is we got our eyes off of the mark a lot of times. And God has a purpose for every one of us. Well, Pastor, you don't know what I did. You don't know where I come from. It don't matter. God still will use us if we'll just turn to him and trust him. But look what he said in Exodus 2:2. And the woman conceived and bare a son. And when she saw him, that he was a goodly child, and she'd hid him 3 months. See, right off, mom knew, okay, there's something special about this child. You know, when I think back, you know, I do thank the Lord for our moms, because they can see a whole lot more in us than we see in ourselves sometimes. Right? Moms want so much more from us than we're willing to acknowledge. Right? And I'm guilty as charged. I can always remember, oh, here we go again. And, you know, Greg, you shouldn't. That was always the word, you shouldn't. Because I was doing things I shouldn't. And she'd be saying, Greg, you know that ain't right. And no matter what, even if I'm trying to get away from mom, and I'd go see, my grandmama's name was Mammy. We called her Mammy. I'd go see Mammy, and Mammy, people always know, she had the biggest Bible in the world sitting on that coffee table. And she had the pictures of all her little grandbabies, and everybody in it. You could open it up, and there was the life history. Some we just hoped nobody would open to see. Because when I grew up, let me tell you something, the only thing we saw was shears, and all the young'uns looked like none of us had no hair. We always stood in a row, and she'd always keep these pictures. But as soon as I'd sit down, I didn't have to open my mouth up. Mammy would say, well, Greg, you know you ain't doing right. I said, have you talked to Mom? Yes, I have. But the thing about it was, is we got to understand something. Moses' mom, She saw something just like so many moms see, something special in each one of us. In fact, in the book of Acts 7:20, they made even another comment about Moses, about how important it was to this mom. She saw something special. Why am I driving this home to you? Say, what's the deal? Okay, we know Moses is special. Yeah, but every one of you are special. Moms want the very best for our children, don't they? Moms do, without a doubt. In Acts 7:20 says, in which times Moses was born and was exceeding fair and nourished up in his father's house 3 months. All right, now take note. He's a good child. He was a proper child. He was exceeding fair. You know, these is all reactions from what? A parents. These parents, all of them said, hey, wow, you know what? My child is special. Anybody ever said your child is special? Everybody says, I got the nicest children in the world, right? Y'all need to come to the altar. This is, yeah. Mine always told me I'd done my best work sleeping. That's it. That's the only time you stood out of trouble. Amen. I heard that over yonder, right? But see, remember the reaction of the parents this morning as we celebrate Jochebed, the mother of Moses. She loved Moses as he was and expected the most out of him, just like so many moms do. Listen, the Bible tells us that the child should be a blessing and not a bother. You know, I thank the Lord for moms. I really do, because now my mom, you know, my dad was hardcore military. His way of getting your attention wasn't the kind with a loving hand. It was a hand. But it wasn't the one he wanted to get. But mom, somehow or another, mom would always sit down and try to reason with you, trying to say, okay, you know, and they would listen to you. And then you'd better listen to them. But the thing about it is, as children, we need to understand something. We're supposed to be a blessing to our moms. You know, I thank the Lord every day that my mom lived long enough to see me come out of where I was at. I am so thankful that mom got to see that, hey, look, you know, her prayers was answered. Ain't y'all? But my mom would tell me on the phone, she saw and she, and look, and I won't in a pretty place and we won't go there because this is not the kind of service you tell. But where I was at, mom would say, Greg, I'm praying. Sometimes it was in another state. Sometimes it was different. Well, 99% of the time it was somewhere I shouldn't have been. But mom would always be praying. And I really believe she was praying. And you know what? What moms pray. Now, Dad, you say, what about us? This is not your day. This is about moms. And this is about how, now, look, we say, now, my mom, she was a good woman. She really was. But we were raised in a hard time. Yes meant yes. No meant no. We never learned maybe. When mama spoke, you know, you learned one thing. If mama didn't get your attention, then it was handed over to the deliverer, which was your dad. And mama says, look, don't make me. And I knew right then, now's the time to shut up, give up, and let it go. Amen? But mom was always the one that I could tell had compassion. How many of you, whenever you done something, anybody ever hurt yourself and run to mom? Yeah, I didn't run to my dad. Because look, he beat you and asked questions later. Why'd you do this? Mom would have compassion. You know, my mama said, do not, absolutely do not go up there in that barn and mess with that hay. Don't you do it. Well, guess what? You did it. And then we thought we could fly because we'd heard of Superman. So I tied on me what we called it burlap sacks because we used them around the backer beds of the truck. So I decided to sail out the top. Of course, I had hay down there. But it didn't land as it planned. And of course, I had a sister, a younger sister. Anybody got a younger sister that just loved to tell on you? And every single time, look, and then when I dived out, of course, I didn't fly, so I knew that that weren't going to happen. But when I landed, I knocked the breath slam out of me, and I didn't know what was going on because I never had that to happen. I was going, and, you know, I was like, uh-oh, it's over. Well, my sister, she might be listening. She runs to mom because I'm laying there like this. And my mom's a nurse. So by the time she got me up and got the air back into me, she beat it back out of me. She warned me not to go up there and do that, and I didn't listen. But in all retrospect, mom always did have compassion. And this Moses' mom, she had compassion for her son. She loved him. And listen, this child, she was a blessing to him. Did you know the Bible says children are a gift from God? Yeah. Did you know that? Children are a gift to God. I want to prove that to you. Go in Psalms 127, 127:3. Because this is important. Because let me tell you how you got here. If anybody read my devotional that I put out this morning, let me tell you something. I told people, I said, we need to thank our moms because, listen, God's creation was brought into existence by using moms. Moms are special because they are what God uses to bring you in to this world. In Psalms 27:3 says, lo, children are an heritage of the Lord, and the fruit of the womb is his reward. You know, and children, you know, moms play a very, very important part in it. You know, my mom used to tell me, I brought you into this world. Yes, sir. Y'all all know that one. And I'll take you out. And you took that to heart. But moms are what God uses. God didn't just come up with something, an afterthought of what should happen. Moms are special. And this is not only to the moms, but children, we're special. We're God's children. God loves us. And just like he did Moses. Now, Jochebed, the mother of Moses, she risked her life for her son. That's why I wanted to bring this particular mom into this message this morning, because she risked her life for her son. In fact, she violated the law that was passed down by Egypt to save her son. Let's be honest with you. How many of you would give your life for your child without even hesitation? We wouldn't hesitate. But a mom's is deeper. Because they conceived, they brought the child into this world. They understand better than we do. So she saw this as there was no way when Moses was born. She said, okay, I know what the law says. But she knew she could not, because she didn't obey the law of the Egyptians. She obeyed the law of the God of Israel. And she didn't. And when she didn't obey that law, it was she. How did she not obey it? She didn't allow them to have her son. And if you know anything about that time, they were taking all the babies and they were killing all the babies. But she hid Moses. She risked her life to save Moses because she was not going to let the law of the world control her son. And what she did was this. She did something very awesome. Listen, she did not listen to the law of what the world says. There's a time that you can break the law. You say, uh-oh, the preacher's talking about go break the law. Well, I want to tell you what the Bible says about that. We ought to obey God rather than the law. Did you know the Bible says that? Just curious if anybody knows that. In Acts 5:29, I want you to turn there so you won't say, well, the preacher said that we could break the law. No, whenever the law of the land goes against the law of God's word, we're supposed to obey the law of the land. Well, preacher, are you sure about that? The old saying is, the writing's on the... Then Peter and the other apostles answered and said, we ought to obey God rather than man. Now, where am I going with this? Yes, because the law of this world is not of good no more. Amen. The things of this world do not line up with the things of God anymore. So listen, what has this got to do with mothers and children? If we don't bring up our children in the admonition of the word of God, that means that we don't have no hope. That's why drugs and alcohol and addictions and so much violence is raging, is because our young people are learning in general more of the world than they are of the word. We have a responsibility, just like Moses' mom did. She obeyed the law of Israel rather than the law of the world of Egypt, because she knew that what they were doing was wrong. Listen, just because they make a law, well, wake up, 2022. 90% of what they make up now has nothing to do with God.
Amen.
Nowadays, they want to take parenthood slam out of the picture. You're not allowed to say a woman or a man. They want to take away so many rights, but what our only hope is that we get back to the word of God.
Amen.
And we stand on that word of God for every area of our life. Amen. I think, you know, again, moms, if it was left up to, you know, me in general as growing up, I'd have never walked into church. Because my dad didn't want it. So, you know, it was hard for mom to get up. We had what we call a bunch ahead of youngins. You know, when you're a bunch ahead of youngins, right? You know, you had a whole lot of them so they could do a lot of work back there in the farm. But mom would. Now, mom would snatch you up by the nap of your head. You were going to church. I can remember as a little kid. That's why one of my ears is stretched longer than the other. Because she, look, if you even looked at her like you, I ain't going. My daddy ain't got to go. And that was it. Boy, that ear went, and you better go with it. Because she would make sure you got there. But, you know, as I look back, you know, I thank Mom because, you know, she went against so much. Back in the olden days, can I be honest? Back in the olden days, the men didn't go to the church. It was women. It was moms. I know one of the first churches I ever pastored, I went in and I said, where's the men? And it was the women. Now, I'm not knocking y'all, so please don't say this is here to insult dads. No, I'm just saying moms play a very important part. And I thank the Lord for the moms that stepped out of the norm to go to the trouble of bringing you to church. Let me tell you why they want to bring you to church. It's because, see, they see what God sees, a creation that's designed to carry out a purpose. And every one of us are here, and because of moms. Everyone, even you moms are here because of a mom.
Yeah.
Did you know that? There ain't nobody here that didn't get here by a mom. If you did, raise your hand. I want to see you. Every one of us is here because of that creation. We owe mom so much. In spite of the commandment of the king that said, listen, you can't do this, we want him. She still went and she hid her son because the mom loved her child so much. She was not afraid. And because this woman was not afraid, guess what Moses got? Moses learned not to be afraid and give him courage to step out of the situation he had in Egypt because of what his birth mom, what his mom taught him. And Hebrews 11:27, she had taught him about courage and listen, and it gave him the courage to never give up. The mother of Moses, as we know as Jochebed, she imparted faith to her son. The greatest thing that we can give our children is faith. I think one of the worst things that's ever happened in America alone is taking faith out of everything.
Yeah.
Our children need to understand faith. She imparted, this mother, and she imparted faith to Moses, because Moses could have went out and done what he wanted to, but when he found out about his birth mom and everything, he came back to that faith, and they taught him. That's why God used Moses. Moses was used because of the faith that was imparted by his mom. I'll never forget what my mom did and the things that she told me. Even though at the time I didn't see it as irrelevant and I didn't think it was of no importance, but I realized that yes, she saw something. See, what moms see is what God sees. Every one of us in this room need to understand God sees us as special. God didn't make Moses no special than us. In fact, God is no respecter of persons. He created us all in his image and his likeness. We're all special. And the problem of it is when we answer that call, she wanted to teach him, and she did. She taught them about the Lord. She taught Moses. In fact, her teachings would make him a man of faith. So important that he would do great things. Moms, let's be honest. Isn't it wonderful to know that when your child grows up and you they've done good, we're just glad, right? We are. We are. You know, there's a lot of bad out there. There's a lot of situations that go on that things go bad. But let me tell you something about a mom's faith. A mom's faith never quits. I know that when Joan with her son Brian, when everything couldn't have gotten no worse. In fact, honestly, the whole world had given up on him. But the mom, Joan, she prayed. She, no matter how many phone calls she get, she got to the point she was terrified to answer the phone. Anybody ever been there? And that was going to be the phone call. And even when I said, well, all you can do is pray. But the thing about it is, she never quit believing. She never quit praying. And God heard her prayer. Just like Moses, he was banned from Egypt. He was banned from his family, and he had to go somewhere else. Of course, that was in God's plans, because that's where he met his wife. But he was banned. But you know, the mom, Jochebed, never stopped praying for Moses, and she was praying for Moses that he would come back one day. She was praying for she didn't know whether he was dead or alive. But guess what? Was her prayers answered? Did he come back? Did he come back in a mighty way? Did God not use Moses to set the children of Israel free from Egypt? So I don't know about you, but I bet you that was one proud mama. Amen. Listen, mom's faith is what keeps us going. So many times when the world gives up on us, because the world will give up on you. But a mom, even if it's the worst, they keep praying. I love that about moms. My mom always never give up. Even though the world says he will never amount to nothing. Anybody ever heard anybody say, well, they were a mistake from the beginning. They are a mistake to the end. They won't never amount to nothing. Right? But guess what? And isn't it blessing? And isn't it a great thing that God doesn't have to listen to us? God listens to those with a heart for Jesus. The heart of Jesus. And moms that know Jesus as their Savior, he listens to their heart. The desires of their heart. Do you know what a mom's desires is more than anything else? Her family. A mom's desires is about her children doing well. A mom's desires is about seeing their children succeed and make something of themselves. But a mom's greatest desire is the safety of their child and the love of their child. This morning, you know, a mother is patient. Moms was always more patient than men. Can I have an amen?
Amen.
Amen. The men told you once, then it was over. Moms was more patient. But my mom and so many moms, just like Jochebed, she was patient. She was patient. She was patient through everything that she was going through. The plan that allowed her to become his nurse. She was patient because when she got rid of the child for the sake of safety, put him so he'd float up to the Egyptians to his daughter where they would take him. Did you know that her faith was so strong that God even used her? Even after the child was gone? Did you know that God even said, okay, look at this mother's faith. God was in charge no matter what was going wrong. Did you know God actually sent the baby back to her? Did you know in Exodus chapter 2, verses 7 and through 10, go there if you will, actually because of what this woman did and because her faith in Christ and not in the faith of the system and didn't lose her faith, God not only, he blessed her, even though she had to get rid of Moses for his so he could live, he sent Moses back to her as a baby. He sent her own child back to her so that she could nourish the child. That was God. No way in the world could that ever would have happened. And Exodus 2:7 proves that. Then said his sister to Pharaoh's daughter, shall I go and call to thee a nurse of the Hebrew women that she may nurse the child for thee? And Pharaoh's daughter said to her, go. And the maid went and called the child's mother. And Pharaoh's daughter said unto her, take this child away and nurse it for me, and I will give thee thy wages. And the woman took the child and nursed it. And the child grew, and she brought him unto Pharaoh's daughter, and he became her son. And she called his name Moses. And she said, because I drew him out of the water. God blessed this mother of faith, brought that child back to her for her to nourish that child before she had to give it up. Now, why did that happen? That has never happened before, never ever happened again in Egypt with all the slaves. Never happened. Do you know why it happened? Because this mom's faith, believing and trusting in God no matter what was going on. This mother's faith and patience and waiting and on the promises of God, she didn't ever quit. She never wavered. That's what moms do. What we need to do is this. And that's what leads me to this part here. Jochebed, the mother of Moses, she enabled her son to take the long look in life. Now, what do we mean by this? Simply put, Moses saw the temporary nature of sin, but only for a season because of what the mother instilled in him. Sin was living in Egypt with Pharaoh, Ramses the son, and all that family together. Moses had everything he wanted. I mean, he was a princess, had everything he wanted. But when he saw his people being done wrong, Moses took a stand because of what was taught him. He took a stand. He chose to suffer with the people of God rather than enjoy the sins and the pleasures of what was going on in Egypt with Pharaoh and all that they had. He came to believe that the eternal riches of the Lord are more important and he, by doing that, by learning that, he learned to walk by faith. Listen, he actually took a long look at life and said, okay, I am not going to try to do it this way. I'm not going to deny who I am. I'm going to go back and I'm going to be with my family. What was the reward of Moses' mother's faith? Well, good gracious. Moses was chosen to deliver God's people. No big task. All her efforts to train him and teach him the faith were totally rewarded. Neither mother, listen, and this is so important. If a mother trains up a child in the way they should go, yes, they may depart. But that don't mean, listen, God can't lie. Just because they don't part, that don't mean they ain't coming back.
Amen.
Let me tell you, I've not met nobody that has been perfect since they were born. Anybody been perfect since you were born? No. But the thing about it is if we have something that we've been instilled in us, it comes back. You know, people say, you know, I don't know, some of my family's gone out here. But let me tell you something. The Bible is important. If we impart the faith of the Word of God, let God's Word do the rest. Keep praying and believing. Don't give up. And I say this because, you know, my mom didn't give up on me. I wish I could say I got saved at 16. I've been preaching since I was 18, but that's all a lie. I got messed up at 15 and stayed tore up till I was 38. So y'all do the math. I was a train wreck, and I'll admit it. And I'm not proud of it. But what I am proud of is that somehow through all of that, no matter what was going on, Mom was always concerned. Mom was always praying. And Mom, you know, she just... In fact, she was so shocked. I come to the house one day. I said, Mom, and I always sit on the porch with them, and because they never knew what I was going to come up with. And I said, Mom, I got saved. Of course, you could have heard a penny drop, and that was the first time there was silence in the room. I said, better yet, I've been called into ministry. Now, we had a problem. Mother said real quick, because they knew I had tried every adventure on planet Earth and 90 of them failed. And the only reason why I was alive because she'd been praying. But when I said, Greg, do you realize how serious that statement is? I said, what do you mean? She said, Greg, you don't play with God. She got my attention. I said, well, Mom, I definitely wouldn't have come up here and said that for no other reason. Of course, my dad, he just gets up and leaves out of the room like, oh, well. And it was so funny. After all was said and done, my dad, after I was ordained in the ministry and done everything the Lord had called me to do, my dad come up to me and he said, son, I'm proud of you. I never heard them words ever in my life. I'm proud of you. My mom, she said, Greg, you got a good thing going. Don't mess it up. You have to know my mom. I said, well, Mom, I sure am going to try not to mess this up. But the thing about it was this is so important. This message is important because our moms are important. And so many times we take them for granted. Now my mom has gone on to be with the Lord. And what I wouldn't give for more time with my mom. What I wouldn't give to hear her fuss at me a little bit more. What I wouldn't give to sit down Sundays and eat all that food that nobody wants you to eat. Yeah. Fried chicken, mashed potatoes, you know, all that stuff that's going to kill you. What I wouldn't give to sit down at Mama's table and sit there with Mom and her just wanting to feed us. What I wouldn't give to just be sitting on the porch with her and talk. Moms are important. Don't wait till you lose them to see the importance of them. Thank the Lord for them because you only get one. And we need to be thankful for our moms. We need to thank God that He saw it in His plan of creation to design motherhood. And we need to understand this in this message too, is that this message simply, listen, this is a message about the invitation to mothers. I don't know where mothers are, whether here or all over the world. Listen, this is important. This is a message for mothers to dedicate themselves to the Lord so that they can dedicate their children to the Lord. I'm going to say that to you again. This is a message for mothers all over. It's not too late. I have someone told me that they in their incarceration, I'm from a country, in jail, and they're incarcerated, and I want to tell you, mothers, even behind bars, it's not too late to surrender and dedicate yourselves to the Lord. It's not too late for the Lord to intervene and change the direction of your life so that maybe you can change the direction of your children. Not only is that the message, but this is also a message about salvation. This is an invitation to us all, to those whose mothers have prayed so hard for us. This is important because every one of us need to understand this part of this Mother's Day message. The greatest gift that I realized that my mama ever wanted, I didn't know this, it wasn't to see me succeed financially. It really wasn't. My mama could care less. And on Mother's Day, I would try to find out what could I get her. You know what mama would say? Oh, Greg, just come see me. Yeah, but I want to get you something. I don't need nothing. In fact, if you went to see mama, she'd normally give you a flower she had growing. And it was so ironic. Someone would say, well, get her a plant. I said, you don't know my mama. That's all she has. This woman growed flowers everywhere. And she said, Greg, just come see me. And when I realized that, I said, okay. But the greatest thing I could have done for mama was this. Meet Jesus. The greatest reward I give my mom and dad that I finally figured it out was Jesus. I never knew the impact that would have. That changed not only my life, but my mama's life. Finally, they weren't embarrassed to talk about you know who. Because I was not a good person. I was an embarrassment because I lived such a hard life. But when I met Jesus, I didn't know he was going to fix everything. The greatest gift I gave my mama that day was, said, Mama, I got saved. And then I realized something. Everything that Jesus used my mama to bring me to earth for, everything he put into motion. All of a sudden, everything that was wrong, God started turning it all around. And the next thing you know, God just moved in a mighty way, just like he did with Moses' mom when Moses, all of a sudden, he come out of the country where he was at and come back and was a deliverer. All of a sudden, I'm not comparing myself to Moses, but let me tell you something. When God moves, God don't play. And whenever he moved, he changed everything around. I used to be the black sheep of the family. All of a sudden, they were waiting for me to come to the house and pray before they would eat. Mom says, y'all ain't eating until Greg gets here. He's going to pray over this food. Amen. Now, you look, that was a problem being a preacher because most of them eat on Sunday. They would want to know, can you end service early? We can't eat till you get here. Do you know how awesome that was for Mama to look at me and say, Greg, pray. Yeah. Yeah. Can you imagine a mama going from, where is he? Is he alive? To, yeah. Greg, bless the food. Amen. You say, that's silly. No, it ain't. It's not. Let me tell you, as Mother's Day is here, the greatest gift that Moses' mother got was not on him returning, but seeing that God had sent him there to deliver mama, deliver his own family. out of bondage. God used him, the one that was the outcast, to come in and deliver his family. That's a proud mama. My saying this to you is this. Don't we want mama to be proud? Now, my mom and dad recently have gone on to be with the Lord, but they didn't leave before they told me how proud they are. And I said, it ain't nothing I did. But yes, it is something I did. It's called accept Jesus. Yeah. We want to make our moms proud. Let's do the only thing they've been put here to do. Listen, God created moms. He created them to put you here. And the reason why you're here, the greatest gift that you can give a mom is carrying out the fulfillment of why God put us here. Yes. And listen, that's Jesus. That's salvation. There's a lot of moms sitting in nursing homes and rest homes right now where people don't even go see them. It's sad. It tears my heart up to see it. I know that when I see them and they say, well, Pastor Greg, we watch you on television. I said, well, thank you so much. I said, she said, we don't get no visitors. I said, do you have children? Well, yeah, but they're too busy. Let me tell you something. We should never be too busy to hang out with mom. Period. So I want to just end this message by saying how much I thank the Lord for our moms and how important they are. But I want to end this with two invitations. The invitations is to the moms. You want God to bless your children? Be a blessing to God. Let God see that you put your life in His hands. You want God to move on your family? Let God move in your heart. And this is a second invitation to every one of us. Like me, we want to make our mamas proud. It's never too late. We always can make mama proud by our relationship with Christ this morning. Now, as this altar is open, I don't know what needs you got on your heart. I don't know what problems you face. I don't know what needs you have. But I can tell you something. Father God loves us. Father God cares. And Father God wants to help us in our times of need. So no matter what that need is, let's pray this morning. Let's open this altar with thanking the Lord for our mamas. And praying that the Lord would use us for a generation of people that we're losing. Our young people need moms back. We need moms back, church. We need our moms back to save our children. This altar's open. Bring your knees to the Lord.